Hello everyone, I'm Vice91 and welcome back to Let's Play I'm Really Dumb. I'm just kidding, let's play Tales of Zestiria, but I say Let's Play I'm Really Dumb because I am really dumb. We have been aimlessly wandering around forever when the thing says to head to Western Glavin where Heldoff was. Well, God, I'm so dumb because we were supposed to head towards the battlefield. Remember where we first saw him in the battlefield? Where was it? Whatever. Not Volgrin. Glavin Basin. Remember where we saw him the very first time? Yeah. Well, we can't warp there, so we gotta go to the next best thing, which is here in Volgrin Forest, right next to the East Basin. So that's where we're gonna go. So I'm so sorry. We were prompted to do so. I just completely... I didn't forget, but it had been... Well, okay, I did kind of forget because, you know, sometimes I go for extended periods of time without being able to record, and apparently I just completely forgot that we were supposed to be coming back here. Yeah, see? This is definitely where we were supposed to be. Okay, so I will apologize because I know I've spent... I'm just going to sit here for a second and explain. So I know we've spent the last couple episodes just kind of wandering around areas that we probably had no business being in at the time, but that's okay. I mean... Like I said last episode, we're going to go through those areas eventually anyway. So, I mean, it's like, you know, we went through all that because we're going to go through it eventually. And, I don't know, I'll just skip forward whenever it comes time to formally go through those areas. But anyway, we're back here to see if we can find any clues about Heldoff. So, let's see what's going on over here.
Delivery confirmed. You sparrow feathers definitely know how to secure quality goods. Now, about our next order.
Sorry, but something else has come up, actually. We hope to do business with you again, though.
Felice, Telfrin.
Boss, what perfect timing.
Work?
Yeah, we got...
Hey!
We got something we should discuss elsewhere.
Come on over here.
All right.
Wow, way to be inconspicuous.
We were approached by a secretary from the Rolance government. It looks like a job offer.
What?
Is this secretary the steward to the Emperor?
That's right. Plus, we got some juicy info, too. It seems that the Queen of Rolance is making moves to adopt the child of her late brother.
Interesting. The current Emperor is the son of the previous one, but the Queen wasn't the mother.
Right. And she once conspired with her own son in an attempt to shift the line of succession to him. You remember how that all worked out. You can bet the Secretary hasn't forgotten either.
Sounds fine. I'll handle it.
You're taking the job? You realize this client is our sworn enemy.
Remember the creed of the Scattered Bones. If the job itself is a necessary one, it doesn't matter who the client is. That's what we stand for, isn't it?
Fair enough.
I suppose it is. Gosh, boss, I don't know what we'd do without you.
And that's why I'm the boss.
Anyway, how should we approach the client?
We'll sneak into Pendrago Castle.
Seriously?
Yeah, we can do
it. The client's probably too skittish to come meet with us personally, and a proxy won't do at all. I need to judge the client for myself.
Got it. If we're headed for the castle, I better call up everyone.
Don't worry. I'm going with her. There's some things a shepherd can't ignore.
Huh?
You sure? Is this okay, boss?
Rose, it's looking like the Imperial family has somehow gotten mixed up with Hellions.
We should go by ourselves.
Telfrin, Felice, we'll go by ourselves. It'll be easier to get around that way.
All right. Take care out there, boss.
Yeah, hey, you watch over our boss now. You hear?
We will.
We'll do.
Yeah, we don't need to bring an army or anything.
I feel kinda guilty, getting you all wrapped up in the affairs of the Scattered Bones.
It's really okay. I should be there for you. All the more so if Hellions might be involved.
Finally, it's time. Let's get going to Pendrago.
Dazzle, you're really going through with this?
Better late than never.
What's this about?
You don't need to know.
Oh, come on! Come on, just tell me.
Hey, cut it out. Get the hell off me.
What an adorable couple.
Hey, can it, Pixie? Let's get moving.
Dezel, are there really Hellions in the Rolance Imperial family?
You're slow to catch on. Go see for yourself.
Hey.
Yes, Saray, I know.
It's cool, guys. I love being kept in the dark.
Yeah, me too.
Sorry.
I promise, just a little bit longer and we'll be able to explain.
All right, if you say so.
Fine. Okay, let's go to Pendrago. Where's the save point? Actually, let's speak first. Rose, don't worry about Dezel. It's fine. Thanks. That makes me feel not nervous at all. Yeah, alright. Let's go to Pendrago, shall we? Save point. Let's see. Well, we can't go directly inside, so let's do the next best thing. Really? We can't go to the entrance? Okay, but I guess we can get close. The Gopher's ruins are at least close enough. So let's travel there. And go back this direction. Let's see. Yeah, we gotta go a little bit, but not too bad. Alright, so round the bend we go. I'm guessing there's something outside Pendrago that we have to address first or something, I don't know. Or else it should just let us directly in, but it's not. We'll let this bird chase us. I'm gonna see if I can pick up this herb on the fly here. Yep, rosemary. I'm gonna get this chest too. Oh, stay away from me. Okay, good. Spike shoes, probably worthless to me now, but another inventory item. Don't know how we're storing all this stuff, but guess we're storing it in the cloud. Anyway. Nice little stroll over here, ain't too bad. We're almost there. See, it didn't take too long. Well, there's nothing out here. I don't know why it didn't let me warp to that safe point. Oh, there is something out here. It's Zaveid.
Zaveid!
Somehow I'm guessing this ain't a coincidence.
Yeah.
Just a word of friendly advice. Leave your opponent this time to me.
Don't mess with me, Zaveid.
I'm not messing with you. Especially not now. You can listen to me or not, your choice. But I'm handling this either way.
Like hell!
Fair enough, Dezel. But just so you know, there's two people left that I've still got a score to settle with. And I didn't save these last two shots of mine just to throw them away.
What are you even talking about?
Mickey boy, when a man says he means business, he means business. Don't ever forget that!
Okay!
Now, come at me!
It's on.
This is ridiculous!
Yep, he wants to fight again.
Here goes!
Okay, resistant to earth and wind, so we have Lila with us. That's okay, even though Dezel's with Rose, that's fine.
I'm not letting an ass like you interfere with my plans.
Gonna have to beat this ass first before you can say that.
Why would you say that?
Don't you dare try to keep me out.
Okay, fine, we won't get you out of this battle. I guess that's why he's automatically with Rose or whatever, but anyway. What level was he? 42? Oh, yeah. See, I guess we're like level 50 now. I guess we should have been handling this a long time ago, but... Oh, well, whoops! Sorry. Sorry I'm an idiot. I can't follow directions. Or very obvious prompts. God, I'm gonna have to armatize. I'm just not being smart. I'm not guarding or anything. That's my own fault. But this makes it a little bit easier. Dude, Zaveid, you're not gonna beat us. Just let it go. And almost there. So I'll do it in just a minute. Ow. Ow. He had enough.
Damn. You're a lot better at this than you used to be. Hey, if you can't stop this fool from killing the Hellions, then try using this. Its power can stop malevolence from binding with people.
Huh.
Got it.
I'll give you my very last shot. You can pay me back later.
Why do this?
Hell if I know. Go on ahead. Zaveid needs a nap.
Okay. Really? Right there? What is his motive? I don't understand. Anyway, we got Siegfried, which I'm assuming is his gun, so apparently he gave it a name.
Why don't we take a rest and eat some snacks?
Yeah, we just had a nice little battle. Let's just eat some snacks, shall we? Why do you think Zaveid gave me this? What was it he said? Hell if I know? He was probably telling the truth. Yeah, maybe so. Maybe he really doesn't know. Anyway, Zaveed's gift. We have a skit.
This thing sure is weird. Is that the thing Zaveid gave you? He said that it's a tool that shoots out power.
Yeah, it's a gun.
Yeah. And that's how he gets power to oppose the malevolence. So if you shoot yourself, you gain more power. If you shoot someone with it, you sever their ties with the malevolence.
I suppose that makes sense now.
So it's kind of like a bow that only fires arrows of pure energy. Is that it? These bullets have that kind of power? Presumably. And this is the last one, huh? Looks like it. Assuming we can't figure out how to make more. How about we take it apart and see if we can... No way. I know. We probably wouldn't know how to put it back together if we did that. We need to treat it with care. It's obviously valuable.
An arrow of force.
Dezel, you know something. Tell us. Maybe I should say before going in here. Yeah, I guess I will. Alright, I'm ready. Let's go. We gotta sneak in, right? Let's do it. Oh, maybe not so much sneaking.
We'll have to wait for nightfall to sneak into the castle.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Why don't we chill at the inn for a bit?
Okay. I can do that. Let's see if there's anything around that I need to draw my attention to. Doesn't look like it. Let's go in the inn. Alright, now we have to choose a meal that fits the situation. Drago stew? Sure, that sounds good. It's expensive, but let's do it. Nightfall arrives, and let's see what happens. Oh, okay. Nothing. It's just nighttime now. Alright, so we have to sneak into the castle. Alright. So let's do this. Hey, it's Rosemary. Okay. Lucky that there's no night patrol or anything around here. Although, I thought they had some patrol on the other side of town. I guess they do. Well, I mean, there's patrolmen here, too. Let's talk to this guy, see what he has to say. What can you possibly want at this time of night? Listen, there's a meeting between the church and the knights going on in the castle tonight. You understand the tensions here? Get back to wherever it is you're staying before folk starts suspecting you of sabotage or worse. But I have to sneak in! Let me sneak in! I mean, this is the right way. Is it not? Talk to Rose and sneak into the castle. Oh, got to actually... Oh, but how are we going to sneak in there? Mind if we go check the town out before we enter the castle? If we're going to sneak in, might as well scope the area out before we do. Well, that's kind of what I'm doing. Albeit, maybe not totally intentionally. No, that's the shrine church. Don't need to sneak into there. Really need to get into the castle, which is over there. Saffron. Can't get through that area. Okay. Oh, nope. Sorry. Is there anything else over here that I need to be aware of? I don't think so. Okay, game. What do you want me to do? Do I need to go into the tower? No, I can't go into the tower. First, let's do a cautious sweep of the town, and then and only then can we get down to business. Yeah, I'm doing a sweep of the town, damn it! Alright, what did I miss back here? Nothing down there. Sorry I'm having another failure moment. But I guess it doesn't hurt to be thorough. Searching everywhere. I don't know where else I'm supposed to look. Okay. There's obviously, there's got to be something around here to trigger something. Oh, okay, here we go.
Well, if it ain't the boss.
Really?
Welcome, welcome.
You.
Lunar.
Wow.
But you look like a Hellion.
Something like that.
Oh dear, look at that face. You're scaring me, boss.
We don't have time to toy with the likes of you. Come on, I'll settle this right here and now.
What exquisite anger. It makes me so hungry.
Here he comes.
All right, dude, let's do this. God, haven't seen you in forever. Unknown. No resistance, no weakness, no nothing. Level 41? You're dead.
The malevolence he emits is incredibly strong.
You mean it's just like with the Cardinal before?
Don't think about anything else until we beat it.
Got it.
Yeah, dude, you may have been strong like 5 or 10 episodes ago when I was supposed to actually be here to fight you the first time, but... Now you're really no match for me. And Rose is gonna finish you off. That's appropriate.
You can't just swing your sword around and win.
32 experience.
An umbrella around.
Wow. And yet Dezel still got a level up from that. Alright.
Damn it! Still not enough?
It's the end of the line, Lunar.
No!
Got it!
What's happening?
What is this feeling?
Everything's in black
and
white.
There's someone else here.
What the crap?
Might you refrain from acting out of turn?
That voice! Shut up! Don't interfere with me!
Foolish, reckless fox. Your role was to lead them on, if you recall. If you act recklessly and provoke his anger, what will we do then?
Who's talking?
Wait! This wasn't the plan. But I'm flexible.
What?
Whoa.
What the hell?
What the?
Okay, well, this could become a problem. So now there's three of them. Okay, yeah. That, okay. This could be an issue. This is really weird. I knew that first fight was a little too easy. Didn't make much sense. Get him, Dezel.
Not half bad for a worm.
Alright, three up, three down.
Or you'll lose him,
yeah,
girl.
Where'd he go?
Surely you won't let him get away with such a vile betrayal.
Then that so-called job offer.
It was a trap.
Damn it.
Great.
Quit messing around and show yourself!
What's your hurry? Relax. This is just the opening act.
Oh, screw you.
When you're good and dead.
Yeah.
Dezel, do you know whose voice that is?
Well, he obviously does.
How could I forget? That's who I've been after for so long.
What?
Haven't you noticed, Lila?
I have. There is no malevolence within this domain.
Huh.
Meaning... Lunar!
Get back here, you jerk.
Yeah.
What? What is it?
What is going on?
I don't know. Everything's color. Oh! Oh, it's her!
Rather productive for an opening act.
Still don't know who she is, but that, you know, we've seen her.
You've shown me, girl. If it should blossom into hatred. Oh, but how happy he will be!
Who is she?
I've waited so long.
Indeed, the time is ripe for both of us.
Care to explain?
Wait, Dazzle! She's not a Hellion!
Like I give a damn. You turn my friends into Hellions and drag the name of the Windriders through the mud?
What are you talking about, Dezel?
Do you mean to say that the girl still doesn't know?
Well, no one told her.
Splendid. Oh, how splendid. The perfect scene has been set.
Dezel, no!
Let me go. This moment is what I've been living for.
Everyone stop. This whole thing is wrong. Saray, Dezel, what's going on?
Dear, dear girl. Let me fill you in. In a desperate effort to preserve and continue the Windriders, who were his last concrete connection to his dead comrade, this Seraph abused your remarkable resonance to periodically commandeer your body, steering you all into the darkness, recreating the Windriders as an assassin's guild. Then, in his quest to kill a Hellion, he set his sights on the power of the Armatus, using you over and over as a vessel to enact his vengeance. It was all right, he thought. It was all to avenge his friend. I do wonder if you agree.
That's right. And to take my revenge against you, I would do it all again in a heartbeat!
That's enough, creepy little girl, for now.
Yeah, there's something wrong about all of this.
Let's get out of here!
I think not.
Whoa, what
the? She became a Hellion? Why?
If words alone won't make you remember. Well, like I said, I'm flexible.
So, you show your true colors at last.
Dang it!
Oh god, oh, poor Rose too. Fuse face, really? Okay, level 50, this is more up our alley for a challenge here. Seriously though, couldn't come up with a better form.
That's the only reason I live!
Oh, how lost you are in the delusion of self-affirmation.
What are you saying?
It's quite pitiful, really.
Get
the
behind this thing.
How you got like this. Think hard. What was it that you truly desired?
Shut up. Yeah, seriously.
How and why did you lose your friend after killing a Hellion? What happens to its malevolence? Are you really so sure?
Yeah, shut up. Jeez.
Lila, get ready to purify her.
Not this time. I'm gonna kill her.
Dezel!
Oh god.
What?
You mustn't! There's no other way. No,
He's broken the pact?
What?
Dazzle!
Tisk, tisk. I can't let you do that.
What? But why?
Saray, this isn't the time.
All right.
What the crap? Oh, God. Seriously?
I can manipulate the senses of others, deceive them through illusion.
Oh, and since Roses
suddenly turned into a Hellion, precisely. Though for the record, the Hellion was real.
Since Rose is preoccupied, we can only have one Seraph in battle, so that's why I'm on my own here with Miglio.
Lila, use the authority of the Prime Lord to stop Dazzle.
I can't. The Sub-Lord has broken the pact.
Can that even be done?
Not usually. It can't be done from the Sub-Lord's side. My, my, this is getting interesting.
God, they just keep coming.
Tell me what it is you're after.
There's something you should know, Shepard.
Yeah, tell me.
Let me show you exactly what mischief your Seraph friend has wrought.
Does someone care to elaborate? I don't know what the hell is going on.
All he did was merely give his blessing. That's all. But not every blessing of the Seraphim is one that brings fortune to the people.
Finally. Finally, I can kill you! Die!
What the hell?
I really, really enjoy traveling with them. We're so lucky.
Yeah, I'm truly grateful.
Dude, Dazzle wasn't the one who was wearing that. It was his comrade.
And of course, I want to bring the Windriders under Rolance's wing. You're the greatest in the land.
But engagement to you, Prince Conan? It's like a dream.
She was engaged?
I'm sorry to see our journey end, but all's well that ends well.
No. I don't want this to end.
Don't let up out there. Go!
Prince Conan, the captain is missing!
Get away from her right now!
Who are you to order me around?
He's already a Hellion.
Huh? Who are you talking to?
You all smell so delicious. It's driving me wild!
How could he have completely turned into a Hellion in such a short amount of time?
Your Highness, what is this nonsense about us killing the first Imperial Prince?
What?
Guards! The traitor scum are here!
A trap, huh? You sick lunatic.
How can this be? It appears that Brad, the leader of the Windriders, has murdered the Prince. He is already in custody of the Pendrago City Guard. All other Windriders are likewise under arrest.
Understand? It's all because Prince Conan became a Hellion, and at the urging of his Hellion greed, he sought to eliminate all hindrances. And by now, I imagine that you've already guessed what made him a Hellion. Have you not? Him.
I might be willing to pardon you, at least, if you'll agree to be mine.
What?
Oh, come now. You'd be the kept woman of the heir to the throne!
A greater honor does not exist.
Why you?
Come on!
Your blessing. Do you have any idea what people call those with this kind of power? Angels of death.
It was all my fault. All my fault.
Whoa.
Looks like someone finally remembers his past.
No!
Jezzle! Move it!
And now the real fun starts, Shepard. Pay close attention.
No!
Rose!
Dazzle, don't move. Got it?
Why you?
You mustn't! Rose is horribly wounded. Even if you purify the malevolence, she doesn't have the strength to handle the burden. You must attack now. Rose will...
If we don't do anything, Rose will become a Hellion.
Yeah, seriously.
The wounds will kill her even before that happens. A Shepherd is faced with difficult choices sometimes. Isn't that right? Better decide quickly, Shepherd. Your darling comedian doesn't have long.
Silence! Crap. I don't know what to do. What, I can't attack? Oh, God.
Hold it, Soleil. Get back for a moment. I have a plan.
Okay. What? Care to fill me in, Dazzle?
Oh, Shepard. Do quit your desperate flailing about. Risk making a mess of the grand stage I spent all this time preparing.
Sorry. Listen.
Dazzle, don't push yourself.
Just listen to me. We have to sever the bond between Rose and the Hellion.
Even for the Shepherd, that would be nothing short of a miracle.
It's impossible.
Sorry. Hand me that thing. You cut from Zaveid.
Yeah, we know that can do it.
It can fire strength itself, right? And I shall be that strength.
What?
I shall be your attack.
What do you mean?
Even as he is absorbed into the Hellion, he'll become an attack with a will of its own. He'll find the bond between Rose and the Hellion and sever it without hurting her body.
But that's just suicide!
If I can summon up the last reserves of my strength and merge them with the power stored in this one remaining bullet, I can stay myself long enough to break the bond while leaving Rose untouched. Sarai, neither Rose nor I can afford to waste any more time. You understand, don't you?
Jezzle? No!
Counting on you. Don't mess this up.
Dude, this is crazy. All right. Holy moly.
Rose, I'm so sorry. It was me. I caused you, the Windriders, everyone to suffer. It's all my fault.
That's what was bugging you? I suppose from the outside it looked like we were suffering. But as far as I'm concerned, these have been the happiest years of my life. 5 years ago, when everything went pear-shaped, we could have been tossed to the winds. But instead, we got to travel again together as the Scattered Bones and the Sparrow Feathers. I was so happy. In fact, I'm grateful to you. Really. Hey, come on. There's gotta be more you want to say.
I'm useless. In the end, I wasn't good for a damn thing. But I can say I did one thing right. Just one. And that one right thing made everything else worthwhile. I'm eternally grateful to you too, Rose. Thank you.
Yeah.
Tell Saray and the others that it wasn't all bad. Romping around those ruins with all those nutballs.
I will.
And if they get bummed out about this, tell them, hey, I thought you had good to do in the world. Keep moping and crying, and I'll chain you up so tight you can't even breathe. And then, give them a good kick in the ass for me.
Yeah.
Good luck out there. Keep on keeping on.
Yeah!
Rose!
Oh, thank goodness! So, how does it feel? What do you think, Shepard? To be as infatuated with someone as he once was? Is it not right that Seraphim, whose blessings only cause misfortune, should not be allowed to exist? Was not his very existence evil to the core, and deserving of extermination?
Lies!
You've got quite a bark, girl. Those are some plucky words from one who once sought to kill the Shepherd for the same reasons.
Who are you anyway?
I am Simone. Like him, a wretched, pitiable seraph, burdened with countless sins. And now, Exeunt.
Wait!
I suggest you make time to grieve.
Holy crap.
I told everyone to meet here tomorrow morning. Sometimes it's best to be alone for a while.
Thanks, Mikleo.
Saray, don't worry about it too much. I need a bit of a walk myself.
Wow. Dezel's gone. Good. Lord Almighty, that was a lot of information to digest. And I suggest taking the time between episodes to do so, because I think I'm going to call it an episode here before we, I guess, go talk to everybody. Oh, man. Well, we finally see the truth that was exposed about Dezel to Rose. And then we get a glimpse of understanding Dezel's motive this entire time, of why he even wanted to tag along with us just for an opportunity at revenge, which is what he finally got, but didn't quite work out how he hoped. Of course, saving the one that he presumably loved was enough for him. Wow, that was a lot. That was intense. And I'm just trying to digest it all myself, but, man, that was crazy. Still don't know exactly who Simone is, other than another Seraph who was apparently aware of the deeds that Dezel had done all this time and had been kind of watching from the shadows this entire time, but goodness. Alright, well, it'll be one to sleep on, so I guess this will do it for today. Next time we're going to kind of go through the aftermath of what all just happened, so thank you guys for joining me. Hope you enjoyed it. And next time, we'll see what else we can find out and see how everyone reacts. Maybe talk to Rose and see how she feels about all this. But anyway, that'll have to wait till next time. So until then, you guys take care, and I will see y'all later for more Let's Play Tales of Zestiria.